semester class. Today I am going to commence P block elements for second year students. Okay, so it is a more interesting topic because we are finding all type of elements in P block. Okay, first I will give you the introduction to periodic table, then for P block, then I will go to particular group. Okay, so this is our modern periodic table. We know that we are grouped. Okay, this periodic table contains 18 groups. These okay, these columns are called groups. Such 18 groups are there. The rows are called periods. There are 7 periods are present. These periods, period represents principal quantum number. We are studied in the first year in atomic structure. We studied principal quantum number. Okay, so then here we are grouped into 4 blocks. These S block, S block, P block, D block and F block. Okay, so we are observing 4 different blocks where the electrons are entering to s orbital, then such elements comes under S block. Okay, if valence electrons are entering into S orbital, then those are called S block elements. The group number 1 and 2 are S block elements. These two are S block elements. If the electrons are entering into p orbital number 13 to 18 13 14 15 16 17 and 18 groups, 18 group element are going to form p block where the electrons are entering into p orbital, p outermost orbital. Okay, then next d block element, here group number 3 to 12, here 13 to 18 and here 1 and 2. Okay, so these are group numbers. These going to form d block elements where the electrons are entering into d orbitals, d subshells. Okay, then here the lanthanum onwards 14 elements are called lanthanides, and 57 onwards, then octinum 89 onwards 14 elements are called octinides, and these two constitute F block elements. We are mentioned below in the periodic table because they will in between D block element. These 28 elements, they are going to form F block element where the electrons are entering into F orbitals. Okay, then the first and second, the group number 1 and 2 we are studied, that S block element we are studied in the first year, and also in P block 13th is boron family and 14 is carbon family, we studied in the first year. And this year we are going to study 15th group, 16th group, 17th group and 18th group elements, and D block elements as well as F block element we are going to study. Okay, so here in periodic table there are total 11 gases are present. 11 gases are present. So look here, one is hydrogen, 1, 2 which are mentioned in red color, those are gases. Okay, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, chlorine, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon. These are 11 gases are present in periodic table. And look here, bromine, it is, which is present in P block, bromine which is liquid non-metal, bromine which is a liquid non-metal, and here mercury, and also here they mentioned mercury which is liquid metal, mercury Hg liquid metal. Okay, so this is liquid metal we are observing in D block, liquid metal and liquid non-metal we are observing in P block, that is bromine. Okay, next. So now I will concentrate on P block element. Look here, the group number 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 and 18th group elements, 13 to 18th group elements are called P block element. Okay, so these are P block element. P block elements. So here, look here, this is 13th group element is called boron family, 14th group element is called carbon family, 13th boron family, okay, 14th carbon family, and 15th it is also called nitrogen family. We are going to study these two, we are studying the first year. Okay, now here onwards we are going to study these are called nitrogen family or nictogens. These are called nictogens. This is nitrogen family. Nitrogen family. This is nitrogen family. Okay, next to group number 16. Group number 16, it is called chalcogens. These are also called chalcogens. Okay. So this is oxygen family. Oxygen family. Okay, then 17th group element, 17th group element are called, 17th group, these are called halogens, halogens, and the 18th group elements are called, 18th group elements are called, okay, so this is noble gases or inert gases. Inert gases. Okay, here halogens means sea salt forming elements, because in sea water we are observing NaCl, KCl, okay, then Ni, like that iodide, most we are finding in sea, and so that these are called sea salt forming, and so that these are called halogens. Chalcogens, these are ore forming elements, like oxide, particularly oxide and sulfide, in the form of, they are available in the form of oxides and sulfides, so that these are called ore forming elements. Nictogens, so these are 15th group elements, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. Okay, these are poisonous elements. Okay, so that those are called nictogens. Okay, so look here, so here in boron family we are observing in 13th group elements. So this is only the non-metal we are observing in 13th group. Aluminium, this is a metal. Gallium, it is a metalloid. Indium and thallium, these are metallic in nature. Look here, this is non-metal, metal, metalloid, then indium and thallium are metals. Okay, next to In P block elements containing all type of elements like non-metal, metalloid and metal. Okay, all these three type of elements we are observing in P block. Okay, so among that, gallium, germanium, silicon, arsenic AS, then SB, silurium, tellurium, okay, these are metalloids we are observing in P block elements. So look here, in 13th group gallium, in 14th group silicon and germanium, we are observing metalloid, then in 15th group arsenic group, selenium and tellurium, we are observing metalloids. Then boron, it is non-metal in 13th group. Aluminium metal, we knows that aluminium metal we are using in electrical wire, wherever we are using, we knows that. So aluminium, it is a metal, and indium, thallium are also metals. Next, in 14th group element, carbon, it is a non-metal. Silicon and germanium are metalloids. Tin and lead are metals. Okay. Next, in the 15th group element, nitrogen, it is a gas, non-metal. It is a gas, non-metal, which is existing in dimer form N2, N2 diatomic molecule N2. Okay. Then, phosphorus, it is a solid non-metal in 15th group. Then, arsenic and antimony, arsenic and antimony are metalloid. And bismuth is a rare metal. Bismuth, it is a rare metal. Rare metal in the sense, the occurrence of that metal is very, very less. Okay, abundance is very less. So, that is called rare metal, rare metal. Next, in 16th group, oxygen, it is a gas. Gas, non-metal, so that is O2, diatomic molecule. And sulfur, it is a solid non-metal. Solid non-metal, this is a gaseous non-metal. Oxygen is a gaseous non-metal. Sulfur, it is a solid non-metal. Then, silurium and tellurium are metalloids. Then, polonium, it is a radioactive in nature. Polonium, it is a radioactive. Radioactive in nature. Okay. So it is a radioactive in nature. Okay. Next to fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, and astatine. All these are non-metallic. Okay. All 17th elements are non-metals. All 17th group elements are non-metallic in nature. All fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, and astatine are non-metallic in nature. These two are gaseous in nature. Fluorine and chlorine are gaseous in nature. And bromine is liquid in nature. Non-metal, liquid. Bromine is a liquid, non-metal. Okay. So, bromine is liquid, non-metal. You have to remember. Okay. It is a liquid, non-metal. Bromine is a liquid, non-metal. Then these iodine and astatine are solid in nature. Okay. Next to 18th group elements are called inert gases because they are not participating in any of chemical reaction. They won't interact with any element. Okay. They exist in free state, monatomic state. In monatomic state, they are not available in, even though they are gaseous state, they are not available in diatomic or triatomic. They are monatomic. Helium, like this, helium only, single atom. Neon, all elements. Okay. So those are called inert gases, and also they are participation with reaction is very, very less. They won't mingle with other elements. They are not forming any compounds, and so that these are also called as noble gases. Noble gases. This 18th group elements are called inert group, zero group, or noble gases. Okay. All are gases, and which occurs in air. Among that, radon is radioactive in nature. Among radon is radioactive in nature, and also astatine also radioactive, 17th group element, astatine 80, astatine also radioactive. These two are radioactive in nature. These two are radioactive. Polonium, astatine, and radon, these three are radioactive in nature. Okay. We are finding in P block. Look here. We are finding metal, non-metal, and metalloid, and also radioactive, liquid as well as solid also we are observing here. And also maximum gases are present in P block element. And this is mercury is the liquid metals we are observing in D block. Okay. So this is the liquid metal we are observing in D block. Okay. Then the elements which are mentioned in yellow color, those are, okay, we can prepare only in the laboratory. We can prepare only in the laboratory. Okay. And all these, most of the elements are radioactive in nature. So that we are mentioned that one in yellow color. Okay. Maximum 118 elements are present. Okay. So this is about P block. Then next, regarding these, these are first, this is hydrogen and helium are first period, second period elements, lithium, beryllium. Next in P block, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, and neon. Okay, they are pi bonds, they are going to form pi bonds. The second period elements in P block elements, they are going to form pi bonds among themselves and in between the elements also, pi bonds they are going to form. Look here, C triple bond C, C double bond C, okay. Even carbon itself, it is going to form pi bond, and also nitrogen also it is going to form pi bond, and also oxygen also it is going to form pi bond, okay. And also between themselves, C double bond O, C triple bond O, okay. So like this, they are going to form pi bonds among themselves. So next to, so magic number. So we are calling magic number. Magic numbers 8, 2, 8, 18 and 32. These are called magic numbers in periodic table. These 2, 8, 18 and 32 are called magic numbers. So for P block element, the magic numbers are, P block element, the magic numbers are 8, 18, 18, 32, 32 are the magic numbers. Using these magic numbers, if you know the 1 to 30, we are well known. 1 to 30 elements, atomic number, we are well known. If you know the atomic second period elements, then easily we can write the atomic number for whole group, whole block, okay. So look here, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and neon. Here helium, it is there, okay. So this is the second period elements. So we know that for boron, it is atomic number is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, okay. So this is the atomic number of second group, second period element, the atomic number of second period elements. So and these are the magic numbers. Already it is, this is 2, okay. So 2 I will forget here. Where the magic number for periodic P block element is 8, 18, 18, 32, 32. Okay. So this is the magic numbers. So look here. You go on add this number by downwards. So 5 plus 8, 13, 13, 13 plus 18, 8, okay. Then we will get 13. 13 plus 18 plus 18. So you will get 8 plus 1, 3, 31. Okay. Next, plus 18. Plus 18. Plus 18 in the sense, 8 plus 1, 9. 9, okay, 41. Okay. Then plus 32. Plus 32. Plus 32, you make it. So 2 plus 9, 1, 11. 11, 1. So 4 plus 3 is 7, 7 plus 8, 81, okay. Then next, then 32 plus 32, plus 32, plus 32 if you make it, then 3, 8 plus 3, 113. You look here, 5, boron, aluminium, 13, gallium, 31, indium, 49, tellurium, 81, then neonium, 113 for neonium, okay. And like this, by using magic number, so we can write the atomic number for all, okay. Boron, we know that 13th group elements, boron, aluminium, okay, gallium, then indium, thallium and neonium. Like that we can remember the element, remember atomic number. You look here, next 14, 32, 50, here 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, okay. Next to 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, okay. Next 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, okay. Then here 82, 83, 84, 85, 86. then here 114 115 116 117 118 is the last element. Okay, so like this we can easily write the atomic number for all elements. Then how to remember the elements, how to remember the elements, look here. This one we are well known, zero group, helium, neon, argon, argon, krypton, xenon, xenon, okay, radon. So up to here no problem. The OG, then 17th group element, we knows that this is 18th group element, this is 17th, 18th group, 17th, 16th, 15th, 14th and 13th. Okay, these are the group numbers, right? These are the atomic number, these are the elements. So the zero group elements, we knows that helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon and again xenon. Okay, next to here we knows that fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine, 80 up to here it's enough. Okay, tenosine ts. Okay, so we knows that helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon, then here fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine. Okay, then here if it comes, then oxygen, sulfur, tellurium, cellurium and polonium. Then here nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth, then mesovium mc. This one is little bit difficult, this one is little bit difficult. Up to here it's more than enough for us. Okay, then carbon family, carbon, silicon, germanium, tin and lead, pb. Okay, then fluorovium fl. Okay, so this we can write the elements as well as the atomic number in the p block. Okay, so the using this magic number is 8 18 18 32 32 are the magic number for p block element. Using that easily we can able to write the atomic number for each element in the periodic table. Okay, general properties, atomic size, atomic radii, electronegativity and ionization enthalpy. It is I'm going to explain for p block, we can extend it for whole periodic table. First I will take up atomic size or atomic radii. Across the period, with increase in atomic number, atomic size increases gradually because the electrons are entering into same shell. Okay, down the group the atomic number increases and electrons entering into new shell, and so that the atomic size increases down the, and also atomic radii also increases down the group. Okay, next to electronegativity. What do you mean by electronegativity? Electronegativity, it is an ability of an element to attract electron cloud or paired electron towards itself is called electronegativity. The ability of an atom to attract the electron cloud or shared pair of electron towards itself is called electronegativity. Across the period electronegativity value increases and it is more for halogen 17th group elements. It is more maximum for 17th group element in each period. Down the group electronegativity value decreases and this electronegativity value is inversely proportional to atomic size. With increase in atomic size electronegativity decreases and also down the group, you see here, down the group the metallic nature increases, down the group electronegativity also decreases, down the group the metallic nature increases, down the group the metallic nature increases, the electronegativity value decreases. So electronegativity is inversely proportional to metallic nature. Electronegativity is more, the non-metallic character is more. Electronegativity value is least, then metallic character is more. Okay, so look here, boron, it is having 2.01, that is non-metallic in nature. You look here, thallium, that is electronegativity value is 1.44, and so that down the group the metallic nature increases. Here boron is a non-metal, metal, then here gallium, it is metalloid, then it is a metal, indium and thallium. Okay, so down the group, metallic nature increases, the electronegativity value decreases. Electronegativity value it is most important. Okay, so across the period electronegativity value increases, across the period from left to right in the periodic table electronegativity value increases. Okay, so next to ionization enthalpy. What do you mean by ionization enthalpy? Ionization enthalpy, it is the energy required to remove an electron from an outermost orbital of an isolated gaseous atom to an infinite distance. Is called ionization enthalpy. It is an energy required to remove an electron from an isolated gaseous atom to an infinite distance. Okay, so that is called ionization enthalpy. Ionization enthalpy depends on size and electronegativity value. If electronegativity value is more, then ionization enthalpy is more. So look here, down the group the atomic size is more, screening effect in the sense number of shells covering the nucleus is more, and so that easily we can remove an electron from an outermost orbital. Okay, and so that down the group ionization enthalpy decreases across the period the electrons are entering into the same shell. It means, suppose if I take 3d scandium, that is d1 configuration, 3d1. So if I go for Fe, d6 configuration, electrons are entering into d orbital, same orbital. Okay, but screening effect is constant, so that effective nuclear charge it will be more, and so that ionization energy increases slightly across the period. Ionization energy decreases down the group due to increase in effective nuclear charge across the period, due to decrease in effective nuclear charge or increase in screening effect, it will be decreases down the group. As atomic size increases, screening effect also increases, effective nuclear charge decreases down the group, and so that ionization energy decreases down the group. Okay, so these are important points we have to keep in mind before entering into the properties of P black element. Okay, so next I will go for electronic configuration. General electronic configuration for P black element is NS2NP126. Okay, this is the general electronic configuration, and before this noble gas configuration we need to write, and followed by NS2NP126. You look here, so P block elements are 13th group, 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th and 18th group are called P block elements. Okay, and here you see, here in 13th group element these three are valence electron, and 14th 4 is the valence electrons, in 15th 5, in 16th 6 is the valence electrons, and 17th seven number of electrons, and in 18 electrons are present. Okay, and here you see, so this is boron. So look here, if I write this one, so general electronic configuration NS2 NP1 configuration, that is the valence electrons, it is the sum of S electrons and P electrons, total number of electrons both in S orbital and P orbital, and that is the valence electrons. Here 13th group NS2 NP1, 14th group NS2 NP2, 15th group, here 4 electron, these are the 4 electron. In the 15th group NS2 NP3 okay. In the 16th group, this is NS2 NP4, okay, 2 plus 4, 6. Then in 17th, NS2 NP5. In 18th, NS2 NP6. So these are the general electronic configuration for each group. This is the general electronic configuration for each group, each P block elements, okay. So each P block groups, 13th group NS2 NP6, that is noble gas configuration, followed by NS2 NP1 P1 configuration, and here 14th group elements P2 configuration, NS2 NP2, 2 plus 2, 4 electrons, and here NS2 NP3, total 5 electrons, and here NS2 NP4, 6 electrons for oxygen family, and for halogen NS2 NP5, total 7 halogens, and in zero group NS2 NP6, 8 electrons. Okay, these are the valence electrons. Okay, and so that we are generalizing 1 2 3 4 5 6 NP1 to 6, we are generalizing this one as NP1 to 6. Okay, this is the general electronic configuration of P block element. You take for example carbon 6. For carbon 6, the electronic configuration is 1s2 2s2 2p2. This is the valence electrons, these are the valence electrons. Similarly, you can write it for fluorine 9. Okay, for fluorine, so look here, this is 1s2 2s2 2p5. So this is the valence electrons. Okay, so then next here, this is about general electronic configuration. See here, for helium, except for helium, so for helium, that is 1s2, except for helium, for remaining elements I have written here, for helium 1s2, then next, so here boron, okay, this is 2s2 2p6, 2s2 2p6, then here 3s2 3p6, look here, so principle, according to above principle, so 1s 2s 2p 7d 7f, okay, so look here, so here so this is the writing of electronic configuration for each element. Here you see, here for 1s orbital only one orbital is there. For second, this is for one period, first period, these are the principal quantum number, these are 6. So here this n is the principal quantum number, n is the principal quantum number, and P and S are, now S and P are subshells, these represents subshells. Okay, so here these are the first principal quantum number, first period only one orbital is there according to Hubble principle. Okay, for second period only two orbits, that is s and p orbits, there is no d orbitals here. For these elements there is no d orbitals, there is no d orbitals. Next, if you go for third period aluminum silicon phosphorus, here there is a vacant d orbitals up to 3s2 3p6, it will get over. For argon it will get over, but it is having a vacant 3d orbitals, vacant 3d orbitals. Then if you go for gallium to krypton, there is a presence of f orbital 4f orbital. Then here onwards we are finding f orbitals, there are four different subshells are present. So here in second period only two subshells are present. So you take for example nitrogen and phosphorus. Nitrogen it can form only three bonds, but phosphorus can able to form three or five bonds due to the presence of d orbitals, due to the presence of vacant d orbitals. The 2s or 3s orbital electrons can shift into 3d orbitals, and thereby they can extend the bond up to 5, PCl5. It is going to form PCl5, but here only NH3 we are observing. NH5 it is not present. Okay, that is because of the presence of vacant d orbital. Due to the absence of d orbitals in the second period, the covalency extends. Okay, for example in a nitrogen that covalency is maximum 4, but in case of phosphorus it can extend up to 6. Covalency is extend up to 6 because of the presence of d orbital. Okay, so this is about covalency. Okay, so they can extend here in the second period onwards, third period onwards the covalency can extend, but it is restricted to total number of orbitals. Here maximum 4 in case of second period, and here it can extend. Here the capacity of each orbital is for s orbital it is 2 electrons, 1 orbit and 2 electron and maximum. Okay, for p orbital maximum 6 electrons can accommodate, and the number of subshells is 3, px py pz. okay, then for d orbitals it is can accommodate maximum 10 electrons, and the subshells are 5, that is dx2 y2 dxy dyz dzx and dz2. okay, these are five subshells. Okay, these are five subshells. Then for f it is can accommodate maximum 14 electrons and 7 subshells. Okay, so thereby if the number of or subshells increases, the covalency also increases, the coordinating bond also increases. Okay, here maximum available is four subshells, so that the covalency is restricted to 4. Okay, so this is about electronic configuration of periodic table. So next I will go to particular group, 15th group element, in the next session. Okay, thanking you.